شيخ مفتي
حبيبي
أنا حزين.
He says I'm very sad.
لأنني سوف أعيش بقية حياتي بلا أم.
He says because I'm going to live the rest of my life without my mother. She's passed away.
أنا أمي توفت قبل خمسة أشهر أو ستة أشهر.
My mother passed away 5-6 months back.
والله العظيم.
I swear by Allah.
أنني الآن أتمنى أمي أن ترجع إلى الدنيا من أجل أن أقبل قدميها.
He says, I promise you, I swear by Allah, I feel within me that I desperately want my mother to come back to the earth, even for a moment, so that I can kiss her feet.
لأن ربي يقول.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا.
Allah has decreed that none shall be worshipped besides Him and that you shall do good to your parents. If one of them or both of them happen to achieve old age in your presence,
فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ.
So don't even say uff to them.
فلا تقل لهما اف ولا تنهرهما.
Don't say uff to them and don't use negative words with them.
وقل لهما قولا كريما.
Say to them that which is beautiful, filled with honor.
واخفض لهما جناح الذل من الرحمة.
And lay for them the wing of mercy. Be merciful and kind towards them.
وقل رب ارحمهما رب ارحمهما رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا.
And pray for them by saying, Oh my Rabb, have mercy on them because they are the ones who actually brought me up when I was a child.
ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه حسنا.
And we have instructed mankind to be good to his or her parents.
ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا.
In another verse, the same thing is repeated. Allah says, we have instructed man to be kind to his or her parents.
الله سبحانه وتعالى ربما كثير من الناس معنا الآن وأباه وأمه لم يدخل في الإسلام.
He says there may be from amongst us some people whose parents are not Muslim.
الله سبحانه وتعالى أمرنا أن نبرهما.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed us to be kind to them too and to fulfill their rights.
وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا.
And be in their company, Allah says, regarding parents, in this world in a good way.
حَتَّى وَإِن لَمْ يَدْخُلَا فِي الْإِسْلَامِ فَيَجِبُ عَلَيْكَ أَن تَبِرَّ أَبَاكَ وَأُمَّكَ.
Even if they are not Muslims yet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it is compulsory for you to be kind and good to them. Obviously, he's the one who chose those parents for you.
أتى رجل إلى نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
A man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فقال يا رسول الله.
He said, O Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من أحق الناس بحسن صحابتي؟
Who is the most deserving from among the people of my kind companionship?
فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said,
أمك.
Your mother.
ثم من؟
Then who else?
قال أمك.
He said again, your mother.
فقال الصحابي من؟
Then he asked again, who after that?
أمك.
He says, your mother, a third time.
قال ثم من؟
Then he says, who?
قال أبوك.
Then he says, your father. After that, your father.
فهل أنت؟
So you, the question is,
صاحب لأمك.
Are you a good companion to your mother?
فهل أنت؟
Are you
أحسنت الصحبة لأمك؟
From among those who did good and kindness to your mother?
فهل أنت؟
Are you
قد بررت بأمك وأبيك؟
From among those who fulfilled the rights of your father and mother?
أريد أن أرسل إليكم رسالة من رجل فقد أمه.
He says, I want to give you a strong message from a man who's just lost his mother.
وفقد أباه.
And who lost his father.
أتمنى لحظة واحدة.
I wish for a moment that they could come back.
حتى أقبل قدمي.
So that I could kiss their feet. لا إله إلا الله.
اللهم استعان.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant his parents Jannatul Firdaus and all those who've passed away, our parents too. Amen.
عندي بشارة للشيخ منصور ولكل من فقد أباه أو أمه.
He says, I have good news for Sheikh Mansour and for anyone who's lost their parents.
أن البر لا ينتهي بوفاة الأب والأم.
That the goodness and the kindness to your parents does not stop at the point of their death.
والصحيح.
And the correct.
أن البر الحقيقي يبدأ بعد الوفاة.
That the true goodness to your parents actually starts after death, after their death.
لأن الأب أو الأم الذي في قبره الآن.
Because the mother or the father who's already in their grave right now.
لا يستطيع أن يحصل على حسنات وأن يقوم بأعمال صالحة لأنه في قبره.
They will not be able to do any more good deeds because they are in their graves.
فقد انقطع عمله.
So all their deeds are cut.
إلا من ثلاثة.
Except three things.
صدقة جارية.
A charity that they had given that is constant or the reward of it continues.
علم ينتفع به.
Knowledge that they may have disseminated in a beneficial way.
أو ولد صالح يدعو له.
Or a child whom they have left behind who will pray for him or her.
والولد في اللغة العربية يطلق على الذكر والأنثى.
And the term ولد in the Arabic language refers to both male and female, a child in the English language.
فتستطيع أن تدعو لهم وأن تدخل لهم حسنات في قبورهم وأن تبر بهما حتى بعد.
So you can actually be good to your parents after they've passed away by praying for them, their forgiveness, and that Allah give them Jannah and protect them from hellfire.
فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا الأحياء منهم والأموات وجميع المسلمين وأن يجعل قبورهم روضة من رياض الجنة.
So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all our parents and those who are alive and those who've passed away and to grant every one of us Jannatul Firdaus.
شيخ مفتي مهما فعلنا لآبائنا وأمهاتنا فإننا لا نعطيهم ولا حقا بسيطا من حقوقهم.
He says no matter what we've done in terms of goodness to our parents, we would not have fulfilled their rights even in a small way.
أتى رجل من اليمن.
A man came from Yemen.
وقد حمل أمه في الحج على ظهره.
Carrying his elderly mother on his back.
من اليمن إلى مكة.
From Yemen to Mecca.
على ظهره.
On his back.
فرأى ابن عمر رضي الله عنه.
So ابن عمر رضي الله عنه saw.
فقال يا ابن عمر.
So he says, Ibn Umar, O Ibn Umar.
Ibn Umar, أتيت من أمي من اليمن إلى مكة على ظهره فهل أديتها حقها؟
He says, O Ibn Umar, I brought my mother on my back all the way from Yemen to مكة المكرمة. Have I fulfilled her rights?
قال ابن عمر لهذا الرجل.
Ibn Umar رضي الله عنه said to this man,
ولا طلقة من طلقاتها أثناء الولادة.
You haven't even gone through a small portion of what she went through when she just gave birth to you.
ونختم.
He says, I end.
بقوله سبحانه.
With the statement of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا.
Allah has decreed that none shall be worshipped besides Him and that you shall be good and kind to your parents.
إما يبلغن عندك الكبر أحدهما أو كلاهما.
If either one of them reaches old age in your presence,
فلا تقل لهما أف ولا تنهرهما.
Then don't even utter the term أف to them and don't say anything negative to them.
وقل لهما قولا كريما.
and say to them that which is filled with honor and dignity, beautiful words of kindness and softness. And you need to lay the wing of humbleness and humility in front of them. And lay in front of them the wing of humbleness, humility, out of mercy, and pray for them that Allah have mercy upon them.
وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا.
Pray for them always that Allah has mercy upon them because they are the ones who brought you up when you were little.
رَبُّكُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا فِي نُفُوسِكُمْ.
Your Rabb knows exactly what is in yourselves.
إِن تَكُونُوا صَالِحِينَ.
If you are good and pious,
فَإِنَّهُ كَانَ لِلْأَوَّابِينَ غَفُورًا.
Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiving to those who often repent and return to Him.